Hello friends, welcome again, and this is my new project Alumni Information System, and I have developed this project in Java, JSP and MySQL, and the version for the JDK I'm using is the JDK version 1.8 and the MySQL version is 5.6. For connecting the MySQL with Java, JSP, I have used MySQL connector, which you will get easily from the mysql.org website. Also, I am running this project on the Tomcat server and I'm using the Tomcat version 7 for running this project, right? So this is the web application. So for front-end development, I have used HTML, CSS, and JavaScript. Some of the jQuery library also have used, like form validations and the client integrations, I have used jQuery plugins. And for many of the things, I have used the jQuery plugins, right? So these all technology stacks I have used for developing this project. So let's start with the functionality go through. So this is the home page of the project. One more thing, this is a major project which has admin and the student login, right? Student can register login, admin can login and see the student details, add the events, right? So let's start. So this is the home page of the project. You can see this is the home page, right? This is about the project. This is a static page and there is nothing dynamic on this page. Okay, so if you want to change the content, then just open the about.jsp and you can change the content here. This is all events, right? So normally for alumni, the main concept is admin can post the event for alumni and alumni can join, means register for the events, right? So you can see this is the login to register, right? So if students wants to register for this event, just he will login, and or if he doesn't have the user ID and password, he can register and he can register for the event, right? I will show you later. So this is event details, and once you click on the event image, then you will get the all programs, right? So currently there you can see the programs are coming which is registered in that event, right? So this is all events. This is a student login from where student will be able to login. This is the admin login from where admin will be able to login. This is the register. So if student doesn't have the user ID and password, then student can register from this page, and after registration he will be able to login. This is a contact us page and it's a static contact us page. I'm not saving the value of this contact us page anywhere into the database, and even I'm not sending the any type of email and SMS from this page. So let's start with the admin login. So user is admin and the password is test, right? So once you log in inside the admin system, then you can see there are lot of menus available, option available here. The same menu option is available here also, right? So let me go through one by one. Home, already explained you. Dashboard, I already explained you. This is an add event from where you will be able to add the events, means admin will be able to publish the events, right? This is at campus interview, so admin can post the campus interview, right? This is an add event program, right? So each event will have some of the programs, so admin can add programs here, right? So this is a report, so events report, all of the events which admin has registered will be able to get the list here. And once he clicks on the view programs, he will be able to see all of the programs here. Event programs, all of the event programs which has been registered. This is a student report. All of the students who has been registered on the website will be displayed here, right? Even he can edit and update the details. You can see he can edit and update the details. This is a campus report, campus interview reports. All of the campus interview which has been added by admin will be displayed here. Once you click on edit, he will be able to update the details. This is a change password from where admin will be able to change the password and the logout. So once admin log out from the system, the above administrator menu will not be displayed, right? So this menu is totally session driven. So let's start with the student login. So the student login is admin amit@gmail.com and password is test, means the email and the password. So once the student login inside the system, then he can see all of the events, right? This one, and he can register for the event. So you can see, if you want to register for the event, just click on the register and you can see you have been registered, and it's saying that cancel registration, right? Once you click on the cancel registration, then the registration will be canceled, right? Again, the registration, right? You can register for all of the events. So student has registered two of the events. This is the campus interview. All of the campus interview information will be displayed here. This is a student my account, from where a student will be able to update his account details, right? So you can see account has been updated successfully. This is a contact us, I already explained you, and the logout, right? So these all functionalities I have developed inside the Project Alumni Information System, right? So this is a major project developed in Java, JSP, and MySQL, and there are two types of login available here: student login and the admin login. Admin can log in, add the events, see the student alumni reports, add the programs inside the event, add the campus interviews. And student can log in, student can register inside the system, student can register for the events, and student can update his account details, right? So these are all functionalities I have developed inside this project, right? So if you need more details or if you need more features inside this project, just put it into the comment. I will incorporate those changes. I will make this project more better and better according to your requirements. And don't forget to subscribe our channel for getting the latest projects videos on the latest technologies. Thanks for watching the video. Thank you very much.